believe so.
Thank you.
Lauren's video clip.
It truly is the governor's house. Because I have a wife, the Countess of Dundee, Charlotte Stuart Murray, and seven children. If you have a wife and seven children, you don't live in a house. You live in a home. The first royal governor to live in that palace is there on the wall. That's Lord or Governor Spotswood. And it was Governor Spotswood's attempt to recreate a fine English garden, which you'll see when you leave the house. And the monies that were expended, someone called it a palace. Well, much of the money for the gardens came out of his purse to start with. So, are you ready?
Yes.
Would you like to, young man in the blue and young lady, would you like to see what it's like to live in a palace? Come along.
Suite on the second floor of that one. So they're used for this building depends on these for other service dependencies. Well, let us go in and see what the palace has to offer.
You're standing on marble. That's most impressive to Virginians because most Virginians live in 2 and 3 room homes with perhaps wooden floors, but maybe not. So this marble tells you much about the men who live in this house. On the walls, adornments to also impress you. This is a terribly unfair question, Lord Dunmore, but I'm going to ask it anyway. Did one word come to mind as you entered the Great Hall? Very 18th century word, but Scottish. It means just what you think it means. Wow. W-O-W. You can find that in Dr. Johnson's dictionaries. One word? Military. And what comes with military might? Power. And so you are reminded that the man who lives in this house, be it me or one of my six predecessors, the power and might of His Majesty is exhibited through me. The power and might of Great Britain is exhibited through me, through all of these weapons. It's what will protect you if the French, the Spanish, the Shawnee were to attack. Now with this warmth of passion arising in the breasts of men like Patrick Henry, bane of my existence, some might see this not as protection, but as
threat. Intimidation.
But we British, free-born Britons, come into this world arguing. We'll argue about anything. We go out of this world arguing. So we hope we get past this argument that we're in now, betwixt and between the colonists, Parliament, and His Majesty, and get on with our lives as Englishmen. Now what you're about to do is unheard of for Virginians, unless your name is Randolph, or Washington, or Lee, or Hill, or Wormley, or Carter. You're going to go above stairs. You're going to go deep into the heart of this home. That's because you're very important people. I can tell by the way you're dressed. So let's go above stairs and see some of the other chambers, what they're used for and by whom. Wish my wife was here. She'd say, husband, you used that correctly. It's not who, it's whom. Come on. While you're looking in the parlor, you'll see a tall case clock. You'd call that a grandfather clock. That belongs to Lady Dunmore and me. As do a number of other pieces of furniture here. Our footman will close the door. Well done. Well, come.
You will not have a room like this.
gosh, I knew that. Yeah, please.